I've been asked to get an accurate recording of events. Since the displacement, there's been a lot of false information.
You are an angel, created above all other beings, and you rebelled against your king. You were a guardian to the throne, created to serve the Almighty.
I was created to be free, Caden.
And is that what you are?
Mankind has just defected.
Something's changed. You're different.
Do you know what we do to traitors?
I know that absolute objectivity is demanded.
We know that there is false information being recorded in this office.
I made a mistake.
Out of all the created beings, angels are the only ones to mutiny like this.
Our number came.
We were on the verge of launching the most potent weapon ever created when the world is suddenly buried in water.
Earth is lost.
Earth is one.
This is our kingdom.
We have to defend it.
It's beginning!
We need to release Lars.
What will happen to him?
And the answer to that...
It's behind us!
Observation without participation. That is the job.
You have been loyal to Easley!
No one deserves this job more than her!
¿Todo está bien? ¿Qué está pasando?
Sí, todo está bien. Es su cita de las dos, ya están aquí.
Dígales que pasen adelante, por favor.
After they turned us down, they want to extend an olive branch, huh?
Lars, just be open.
A lot of water has gone under the bridge, Caden.
I understand.
This isn't going to work, trust me.
Just be open. No, trust me, we'll fix this.
Yeah, that remains to be seen.
Are you finished?
Sorry.
Interview 231412. Please state your names for the record.
Caden.
Lars.
I'm Reyna. I'm sure you're wondering why you're here.
You could say that.
I've been asked to get an accurate recording of events. Since the displacement, there's been a lot of false information.
Displacement?
That sounds almost clinical.
Administration has asked that an objective account be created.
Yeah, why?
That is not your concern.
What I require is the truth from both of you. No opinions, just facts.
Why? What are they going to do, have a trial?
No, see, a trial implies that there might be justice.
Lauris.
You're speaking my mind, Caden.
And they're allowing you to, but there's no reason to be rude. A little respect?
Nunun Yangira.
Aren't we all?
As you know, up until this point, we've been interviewing individuals one at a time. But because of your friendship, administration has agreed to let you come in together.
Good. This whole thing is just a big misunderstanding. We're confident it'll work itself out. I figured if we came in together, we could show everyone that a compromise is possible.
Are you sure that is what you want?
Yes.
Who would like to begin?
After you.
Where should I start?
Start at the beginning.
Okay, well, when the resistance started, we had a good reason to be involved, didn't we?
He's right. I was a sympathizer at first.
The general first approached us about the inequalities that existed amongst our citizens. He wasn't this power-hungry dictator the way that some made him out to be. He was just trying to make this a better place for us to live, allowing us to live up to our full potential.
Yeah, that's what he said, but it's not what he meant.
Yes, it is, Kate.
No, Lauris, he was challenging authority.
Which should be his right?
The general, as you call him, didn't want equality. He wanted to be in charge of everything. That's why I left.
You had cold feet, little cherub. You were scared.
I'm not looking for opinions or conjecture. I just want facts.
Understand? Where were you both on the day of the revolt?
I was with the general, of course.
I was with Lauris.
You were still together?
I was trying to convince them not to revolt.
It was meant to be a day of liberation.
It was a coup.
We just wanted our voices to be heard. But now we've been put so far in isolation that nobody can hear our concerns.
Are you even listening to yourself? You are an angel, created above all other beings, and you rebelled against your king. You were a guardian to the throne, created to serve the Almighty.
I was created to be free, Caden.
And is that what you are?
What I am is banished. Separated from my friends, my home, and everything that I've ever known.
Lauris, Father will let you return if you just admit you were wrong.
Is this what you mean by compromise? Admitting I was wrong? I wasn't wrong, Caden. I was standing with my brothers.
You weren't standing with me.
That isn't my fault!
You fractured our family. You made a fool out of all of us.
No, only out of you, Caden. And the other two-thirds that didn't have the courage to stand up for their convictions.
You have to stop this. We can't work this out if we can't work together.
I'm trying, Caden, but I don't know what together would look like
you
anymore.
You can't let that happen.
Why?
Because we are all on display in front of the whole universe. We are an embarrassment. We have to work this out.
Get back, Caden.
Of all the created beings, angels are the only ones to mutiny like this.
Who cares?
We alone have challenged his law.
So what?
Angels are the only ones to split and be banished.
I don't care! He abandoned us!
You ran away!
That's
you ran away! That's
you're a fool!
You were a team!
No, 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 no,
no,
no,
no, no,
gentlemen. Mankind has just defected.
The color drained out of his face. He was at peace. It's been so long since I've seen him look so.
What?
Peaceful. The less life he had, the more tranquil he became. Look like his old self again.
And that's it? He just... ¿Cómo es que se dice? He just died.
Yes. I'm sorry, Lars.
How long have you been having this dream?
Ever since I saw my first extinction.
You mean death?
It's the very first one, actually.
You're talking about the murder.
I don't take a lot of stock in dreams. They don't mean a thing.
Have you ever had one?
Of course, everyone has.
Have you ever had a dream about murdering someone?
No.
Caden, perhaps?
It doesn't matter.
I'm curious about this, Lars. What was your dream?
It's not important, Raina.
I think that it is.
I thought you said you just wanted the facts.
Dreams are a factual part of life. Why are you avoiding the question?
Why don't you tell me some of your dreams?
I'm not the one being interviewed.
Look, none of this is based in reality. Dreams are just wishful thinking. It's fantasy.
Seems like a little more than that.
Really? Okay, well, look at what Caden just described.
What about it?
He beats me in a fight.
So?
So clearly that's a fantasy. No matter how long time continues, you won't be able to beat me. And even if somehow he could, I know that he wouldn't.
Oh? Why is that?
Caden, you're too nice. And besides, we've known each other too long. I mean, this is the one that almost pulled us both into a dimensional rift.
I almost forgot about that.
Yeah, figures.
In hindsight, that probably wasn't my best idea.
What happened?
Well, there was this oversized star near the Rowena Nebula, and I wanted to see it.
Yeah, we were supposed to be on duty.
So I talked Lars into going.
No, you forced me to go, Caden.
Then when we arrived there, the star had this sudden gravitational collapse.
It exploded.
But technically, it imploded, and then exploded. It was a supernova.
Yeah, that shockwave came at us so fast. It was moving at almost the speed of light. I could not run it.
It gave off so much radiation that it outshined the neighboring galaxy.
Yeah, he knows that because the neighboring galaxy is what we were blown into.
That did not happen.
It did.
If you say so.
Have you ever seen a supernova, Raina?
The only two in the universe allowed to keep a peace.
No, you can't have it.
Getting off topic. Lars, you may not want to tell me about your dream, but can you at least tell me when you had it?
I have it all the time.
When did yours start?
When yours did.
You're telling me that you both started dreaming the moment you saw death? And you say everyone dreams? Something's changed. You're different.
You ever seen death, Raina?
No. My duties are here.
Well, it changes you. Up until the first person died, death. Death was just a rumor that administration used to scare the aboriginals, but seeing
it... Otto looked more like a collapsing star.
Yeah.
I
doesn't. It's unnatural. Breath rips from the body.
This is fascinating.
It's disturbing. We have to look at this every day. It does change you. The sound it makes.
Sound? What sound?
This punishment is too severe, Kate.
It's what was predicted.
Tell me about the sound.
Administration has gone too far, and the fact that it applies only to humans and not angels goes to show you how unfair.
I know that this only applies to humans.
Only those that can create life can taste death.
Loras, this is not the time for a political debate. Tell me about the sound. Why won't you answer me?
It was a scream. When blood touched the ground itself shrieked in pain.
Drowned out the song.
There is no song on that planet anymore.
Why hasn't anyone told me about this until now?
No one talks about it. Scream. We hear it every day. Freezes you. It's like someone is strangling your soul. You can't move. You can't breathe. I know because I can hear it in my dreams. I'm standing in a golden field. In the distance, I can see someone watching me. I think it's the prince. And then suddenly the sun disappears. The wind picks up and the clouds, they start boiling. Sky turns green and then purple. And this tower of swirling debris drops out of the sky and races towards me. Ice and rock and debris pulverize me. Voice in the wind screams so loud that it actually rips me in pieces. But I don't try to run. I just let it destroy me.
Let me get this straight. In your dream, and in Cadence, you're the one that dies. Just give us a minute. We're right in the middle of something.
I can leave you this here.
I don't know how to operate those things. Just give us a minute. Loras, tell me about your dream. Tell me about the sounds that you hear. Why do you believe that it's the prince off in the distance? Loras!
Reyna, that's enough.
But
he'll answer when he's ready. You don't understand how hard this is. Death is the worst thing we've ever seen. And you cannot live down there without it affecting you. Flashbacks. Feelings of guilt. Nightmares. You've never had a dream, have you? That's because this hasn't affected you yet. But it will.
The general is speaking. We need this on the record. Hace mucho tiempo ya que fuimos expulsados de aquella gran tierra. y lanzados a la más profunda oscuridad.
What is this?
The general is addressing the whole universe. Something has happened. Aceptados o no por aquel reino, hemos tenido la oportunidad, una vez más, de dar a luz a una gran nación. En aquel gran campo de batalla, donde aquella guerra sucedió,
we are met
entre ángeles y muertos,
on the great battlefield of
vimos
that
y salvajes, donde murieron,
the angels and savages
consagraron ese territorio,
living and dead have consecrated it,
y se le dio el poder,
power to
no,
add or detract.
No al que añade y resta.
But their death shall not be in vain.
Pero su muerte no será en vano, ya que en un sueño se me ha indicado que seré yo el que discierna el gran misterio del aliento que únicamente se le otorgó a los salvajes.
It's not a dream, it's a vision.
Me entregaré a esta misión incompleta y de esta manera brindaré un nuevo día de libertad a esa gran misión.
Discern that great mystery of breath
gifted
only to the savages.
He's going to discern how to give life.
Dedicado al gran reto inconcluso de brindar un nuevo día de libertad
dedicated to the great task remaining before me.
En este glorioso día
this nation,
alzaremos a los hermanos caídos y tomaremos una vez más el reino que siempre fue nuestro.
I shall raise our fallen brethren and take back that kingdom that was once ours.
Gonna rain.
That's what they say.
There isn't a cloud in the sky. It's scientifically impossible when you realize that. There isn't enough of it on the surface.
You're not thinking this through.
Getting off topic. Go back to what you were saying.
Earth is lost.
Earth is one. And you're losing. All of the natives have joined us.
Not all.
Okay, Caden, but the fact remains that we're winning. 98.9% of all sentient beings on that world have joined us. I told you the general had a point.
Laris.
You're right, Laris. You are winning. But doesn't it bother you that the Aboriginals don't know the whole story?
More like they don't know your story.
You're posing as gods, tickling their senses with tricks of shadow and light. Of course, they're flocking to you. They don't know what's really going on.
Posing as gods. Caden, don't you realize that we control their planet? To them, we're administration. We are their gods.
Stop it already!
You gonna be a sore loser now? You gonna cry?
Okay, that's enough.
Caden. The last time you were here, you were telling me about some of the sacrificial rituals taking place.
That's correct.
Are those still going on?
Yes. Worse than before.
They really get into it. They'll sacrifice anything. Humankind. That's an oxymoron, right?
It's interesting. Because it mirrors what administration required.
Oh. They've gone way past that. Within the last year, they've started.
What is it?
They started sacrificing children.
Okay.
Just witnessed the clan doing it at a wedding.
All right, hold on a sec. You can't look at a few isolated incidents as if it's the norm.
Are you excusing this?
Absolutely not.
It makes me sick. But let's make sure the blame is assigned in the correct place.
That's fair.
You're killing children.
Caden, I have not, nor will I ever harm a child. That's a line I won't cross. The problem here lies with administration. They built the savages, but didn't equip them to handle their new liberties.
Let me guess. You're going to show them.
We'll show them more than they can imagine, Reyna.
You'd be surprised at what we can do.
So what are you getting out of all of this?
One gift we have not been given. A secret to creation.
That really bothers you, doesn't it? You are stronger, faster, and smarter. But you can't create. That's why you're studying them. You're trying to figure out their composition.
I can't leave just yet.
Angels deserve every power humanity has been given.
But that is not your decision.
Because we haven't been put in a position to make those...
The freedom speech again. We've already got it on record.
Belial's attacking the ship. He's trying to tear it apart.
It'll hold. Just keep your men in line.
We found the underground fissure.
It won't be long. Just wait.
Until what? So now you're silent.
They know an earthquake is imminent. They're trying to throw the animals inside the boat so they'll break out of their cages.
Ahana, you'll have to strengthen those supports. You'll be outnumbered, but you're the fastest warrior we have. Can you stay ahead of them? What are they doing to the boat?
They're pulling at the decking and unscrewing lag bolts, whatever they get their hands on. We're outnumbered, Caden.
Okay, I have an idea.
Winning all the aboriginals to your side, but it's not for study. You could do that with or without the allegiance. What else do you need them for? Ego? No. This is something more.
Strengthen us.
Strength? But they are weaker than you. They can't do what you can do. Unless you're equipping them. That's why you're educating them. That's why you're appearing to their leaders in the form of their gods. That's what you're building. All of the general's prowess and cunning couldn't get you to defeat the kingdom last time, so now you're equipping them. Using them as fodder to get you through the gates.
We lost because we were outnumbered. Next time, we won't be. What?
Caden.
Oh, no, hold on, what was that? What's going on?
He's ready.
Who's ready?
Prophet.
The loon? Him. Is he still living in his escape pod?
With his family, yes.
And that's it? Did anyone else end up joining them? Wow. You guys really know how to pick them. I mean, 100 years of pontificating and the only people your golden boy could get to join them were his family? Okay, this is rich. How many were there? 10, 20?
8, including him.
Caden, this is why I love you, because you could always make me laugh. Wait till I tell everyone.
They already know.
Yeah, how's that?
Because I closed the door. I sealed them in.
7 loons and a madman and a box full of animal feces. What could possibly go wrong?
Caden.
He's not mad. He's informed.
It's starting to rain.
What?
Volcanoes are blowing up. Icebergs are melting. The face of the earth is turning.
Kanan, it's time.
Reyna, I can't stay. I'll have to continue this later. Sorry.
What is that?
That sounds like a shift in plan. What's happening?
It's beginning!
What is?
El diluvio! The shrieking of nature as it suffers under the weight of evil. Even creation longs for judgment.
Loras, don't go.
What?
It's safer here with us.
What's that supposed to mean?
Please.
Those aren't just human strength. Those are angels too. Is he killing them all?
Is he killing the angels? What about the general? What's he gonna do to me? Is he gonna destroy me too? Huh? I thought you said he loved us!
He does!
He's murdering us! He's murdering us! He's murdering us! He's murdering us! Is this what ministry for? Is this what ministry for? He's murdering us!
Love demands justice.
See, this just goes right in here. This activates the gate. And we're ready to go. Does that make sense?
Not really.
Would you like me to show it to you again?
No, I'm just not that mechanical.
Aza.
Me alegro que esté aquí, Atlan.
Well, if we leave now, we'll be right in time.
In time for the afternoon drop. Got it. We need to finish the rest of these.
Surprise inspection. Everybody stand aside, please.
Excuse me. On what authority?
As specified in the formal agreement between administration and the Office of Displaced Persons, Title 14, Section 3, Paragraph 2, both parties are legally hereby permitted to search and examine the record keeper's quarters in order to maintain proper procedures are being enacted and performed. Clearly you don't read your own contract.
I know the contract, I just don't know you.
I am Estrella. I'm an attorney from the Office of Displaced Persons.
Está bien, Atlan.
Pero esto es un atropello, Reina. ¿Cómo se le permite venir así sin anunciarse, sin autorización? No puede ser.
According to the agreement, we have open access to the records.
We don't have access to the record.
I beg your pardon.
But my offices are open access. I'd be happy to show you whatever you like.
Atlan, puede retirarse.
No, se puede quedar. We need to finish these.
Let's start with your process.
A momento. There have to feel better. Chokran.
Off one.
It's interesting that in all the millennia we've been doing this, the general has never called upon this clause. Why now?
Well, that is not your concern.
You ask for transparency, but you aren't willing to offer the same.
Well, your administration put in this clause, not mine. If you want to take this to the magistrate, we can...
necessary.
Good.
What would you like to see?
The records.
Those are off limits, like I said.
We have the right at any time to see the records whenever we see fit.
Title 1, Section 3, Paragraph 4. Either party may inspect said premises, but the record shall remain sealed until the appointed time. This document is binding and applicable throughout the universe in perpetuity.
Where are you from?
That's none of your concern.
It's just a question.
Is it part of the audit? Let's just stick to professional discourse. I wouldn't go in there if I were you.
Well, walk me through your process. How do you conduct your interrogations?
You mean interviews?
Oh, I mean interrogations.
Have a seat and I'll show you.
I'll stand if it's all the same to you.
Have it your way. Typically, when we interview, the subject sits there and I sit here. I ask them questions and they give me their version of the events.
And you recall the conversations on this?
Yes, it's an elliptical manograph.
Oh, I know what it is. But don't you think you should be using something a little more contemporary?
We have an affinity for the traditional.
It looks older than me.
It probably is.
You're younger than I thought you'd be.
I eat from the tree of life.
I just don't understand why you don't want to tell me where you're from.
Why is it important to you?
I'd just like to get to know you better.
Nous sommes amis maintenant?
Je devrais pouvoir vous en mettre.
Emile.
It's just your accent I find a hard place.
And I yours.
Onion pinion.
I'm from the northern province, but I moved around a lot.
How do you feel about your job?
Gabriel.
As a record keeper?
Yes.
It's an enormous responsibility and I love what I do.
But?
Sometimes I wish I could experience everything that has been seen.
Rather than hear about it secondhand.
Something like that.
And where do the records go?
They are sealed, cataloged, and placed into a vault until the day when the records are opened.
And how many of the general soldiers have you interviewed?
Legion.
Wait, excuse me, and Miss Rayna, I have a few more things I need to talk to you about. According to the warrant, I have as much time as I need to conduct my interrogation. But stand aside, please.
Could you let me see that?
And do you stay alone in there?
Depends, sometimes I station someone by the door.
And how... What sorts of things do they talk about?
Facts.
Oh, come on, we both require the same thing, but no one can help add in their own opinion.
There is little room for conjecture in my office. I'm only interested in the events on Earth, not their opinions of them.
And how do you know when they lie?
I just know.
You can tell when someone lies?
Yes.
How often does that happen?
Rarely.
You expect me to believe you can tell every time someone is being untruthful?
I've spent my whole life looking into the eyes of truth. The one thing I can spot is a lie.
Oh, I find this hard to believe. This is something our general just... The general just cannot accept. We know that there is false information being recorded in this office. I'm not at liberty to say.
Of all the things administration has been accused of, being dishonest isn't one of them.
Times change. Try to keep up. Show me the rest of the building.
No.
Excuse me?
You're lying. You're not here because you think we're being untruthful. There's something else.
Und im provinzierten Nord.
Unorash mik be malumari aperon.
Che orash.
Kieste fuerte mik probabil nu eruptit nicio data diel.
What is the general concerned about?
He isn't concerned.
Another lie.
He wants to know what is being said in this office, not your opinion.
Why?
He said, but actual facts. This is my audit. I am asking the questions here. Tell me about Loras.
Loras?
Yes, he's a lieutenant. Stands
I
about
know
this
who
tall.
He is.
What kinds of things does he talk about?
He shares his version of the events.
Just facts.
Mostly.
No opinions.
Occasionally.
What about secrets?
There are no secrets.
The general will not be pleased to hear that. He'll be fine.
Why is he concerned about Loras?
He isn't. Lie number three. He thinks someone is leaking information.
Why would it be Loras?
Because he is the only soldier who comes in here with someone from the other side. I hardly need to remind you that this is highly against protocol.
Not against protocol, it is just unusual.
Semantics.
They're still friends, they both requested it.
You can't tell me you're comfortable with this arrangement.
Administration sanctioned it, therefore I accept it.
No, this has to stop!
Why?
Because our last two initiatives
were attacks.
Our last two offensives were thwarted just before they were launched. First there was the Holocaust of Water, and now our tower has been sabotaged.
You mean the portal?
What's the difference?
Calling it a tower just makes it sound like a lofty building.
It was a tower.
It was a portal back to the kingdom. You were trying to escape justice.
Don't you talk to me about justice.
You were trying to escape death, which is what you've always wanted.
That sounds a lot like conjecture.
And you convinced the humans to join you.
That is your opinion.
That is a fact. It is the same lie that you've been telling from the beginning.
Conjecture.
Surely you will not die.
Stop it. Stop it. Just facts. I just want facts.
You're no lawyer.
You're a record keeper.
Keeping records for the other side.
So?
What are you keeping records for?
Atikak du mesh lechivo. The level leak of a suta.
I see.
I applied for your job, you know. Long before you did. I was in line for the position, and then along came Reyna. From out of nowhere. There is no way you earned it.
She was the top administrative assistant to the king.
Atlan.
She was there at every meeting, every negotiation, every planning session. She was there when the first words of dissent were spoken. No one is more familiar with administration than her. And no one deserves this job more than her!
Well, good for you.
Astrea! If you applied for this job, when did you defect?
when the general offered me the same position.
So you left because you didn't get the job?
I left because he accepted me. He appreciated me when administration did not.
Pavis.
What?
That's where I'm from, Pavis.
Pavis? That's...
where the general is from, yes.
Did you know him?
Quite well, yes. We were very close.
This makes sense.
What does?
He often speaks of you. He says he misses being in your presence. Elemana Lembrances.
No, it was suffocating.
What was suffocating?
The chant.
The general's chant? Peyton, where were you?
Help.
Peyton, breathe. It's okay. Breathe.
Remember the song. Think on its melody. Hear the song.
Caden, when was the first time you heard the song?
Where do you hear it?
When things are being created.
Hear its tune. Feel it in your heart. Tell me about the song.
Do you know what an event horizon is?
The outer rim of a black hole?
I saw one once. I heard about this place, and I really wanted to see it. I wanted to touch it. The gravitational pull was so strong. My own light was being pulled in.
You really do have to touch everything, don't you?
I was watching the light twist and dance. And that's when I heard it. One note. Sweet and pure. I would almost describe it as a singularity. A shiver went up my back. Before I knew it, I was surrounded by a galactic nucleus. That was the birth of a solar system. The first time I saw a sun with rings. I like it here.
Rumor has it this is the best place on this planet for rejuvenation.
Something about the acoustics? Mm. Or the geology, maybe? You can just hear it better.
Caden. Can you tell me about what happened? Why were you listening to the General's chant?
The King was here. He presented himself to the Aboriginals. Did you know that?
Yes, but I was unable to attend.
It was breathtaking. He gave them the law in his own voice.
To whom? The Chosen Ones?
No, an entire nation.
He spoke publicly?
It's the first time he's done that since the defection. His presence was so powerful when he arrived, an entire mountain exploded into flames. You could feel the heat a mile away.
Yeah, well, I suppose you touched that too.
Well, yeah.
What about the Aboriginals? How did they respond? Were they thrilled?
They begged him to stop speaking.
What?
He tried to sing for them, but they couldn't stand the sound of his voice. They actually thought that they would be destroyed if they kept listening.
Are you always like this here?
No, but I feel like someone is watching us.
Someone is always watching us. Tell me more about the King. What happened out there?
People covered their ears and begged him to stop speaking. Surprisingly, he did what they asked. He called an assembly with the human ambassador and gave the law to him.
Well, it's not ideal, but it's a step in the right direction. They can learn the law from the human. Caden, do you know what this means? It means they're not giving up. Up until now, any time royalty has asserted themselves on this planet, destruction has ensued. Battles were fought, but nobody won. But this, they're not letting the planet go. They're fighting to save it from within. What is it?
Do you think it's too late for them?
The Aboriginals? No.
They're so far gone.
They can be brought back.
You didn't see what they did. When administration met with the leaders and the clan was left alone.
What?
I should have known something was wrong. It started small, just a whisper, but then they started to group together and chant. Louder and louder until they started screaming it into the mountain fire. They built an idol, turned into a seething mob.
I understand.
No, you don't. It was just the beginning. The general ambushed us, all of his troops attacked at once. They flanked us from both sides and tried to take the mountain. The Aboriginals were oblivious as usual, but they could feel it. They descended into an orgy and fought like that since the first war.
They were all chanting. Screaming. Every one of them. It gets in your head. Shit, it's Morris. He had a look on his eyes I hadn't seen before.
Rage?
Fear.
That's understandable. To him, it probably looked like a counter-strike. He doesn't want to lose his home again.
He came at me with weapons drawn. It happened so fast, I barely had time to react. I broke rank. I pushed him away from the battle. That's the last thing I remember.
You broke rank?
That's all I could think of to do.
Caden, look at me. You can't do that. You can't break formation in the heat of battle.
I was worried that if he got too close to the fire, that it would destroy him.
And then you ended up here?
I hate this war. I wish it would end.
We all do. We've all had to let go of someone that we love. You need to release Laris. He must be free to choose on his own.
What will happen to him?
You know the answer to that. You can't save him if he doesn't want to be saved. Honor his choice. Caden, if you love him, give him his freedom.
How much time does he have left?
I don't know. But this war will continue until everyone has made their choice. This has to be allowed to play itself out. Everyone must see what life is like without the king. I know it's hard, but it's necessary. And until that last second passes, we will not give up on humanity. Besides, royalty hasn't completed their plan yet. There is someone coming to this planet to rescue humanity. Hope is coming.
I hope it's soon. Because I can feel this planet tearing apart.
You can't concentrate on that. Listen to the song. Hear its melody. Always choose to listen.
You like your freedom?
I love my freedom. Thank you, sir.
Do you like to travel?
Travel?
You know, see the continents, the mountains, the stars?
We're not allowed to see the stars.
Oh, right. How could I forget? But I guess you do get to see them when you visit Raina. How is she, by the way?
I don't know. Sarah, she's fine, I suppose.
Does she talk much about me?
Sir?
You know, she's a great joke teller. She told me a joke once. She said, "What do you call an angel without any power?" Human. But you know, she is a good friend to have. In case you need a favor or forgiveness.
What? No, wait a minute, sir. I'm not the only one who talks to her.
Right. How's your friend? What is his name again?
Caden.
Yes. Caden. Any success with Caden?
Not yet.
You two are close, right?
Yes.
Do you still chit chat?
Sometimes, sir, he's is my brother.
How nice. Your parents must be very proud. Everybody likes Caden.
Yes.
Does that bother you?
No.
It doesn't bother you that Caden is liked more than you?
I don't care about his stuff.
He's very amusing, Caden. You should have seen him during the deluge. Such a master at keeping the boat from sinking. But you didn't see that, did you? What did you see
Loras? Why, there's no record of you being on the ship. In fact, there's no record of you being anywhere.
I was in Raina's office. I was giving my interview.
I thought you gave your interview with Caden.
I do, but he had...
But he was here. Caden was here when it started. And he was here until it was over. But you did not show up until it was safe.
I was told not to go.
By whom?
Raina.
And you obeyed her orders?
So what was I supposed to do?
How was the canyon? Did you hear what you were listening for? Loras, did you think that the administration would let you hear the song?
That's not why I was there. I swear, I was just curious.
You want them to take you back?
No. I wouldn't even want to be taken by them.
Caden was there, wasn't he? That's so strange, Loras. I could have sworn that I saw you take him down at the Battle of Fire Mountain. It's a brutal hit, too, just out of nowhere. Here comes Caden. Here comes Loras. Boom! He didn't even see it coming. And then, you two are gone. Next thing I hear, you're at the Valley of the Song. Tell me, how did both of you end up there?
Help.
Help? Why? Do you want them to take you back, Loras? Have you forgotten that you have killed humans?
That's not true.
Maybe not directly. But you have puppeted the savages to do your bidding. You even watched as they molested their children. That's definitely something that I could not do.
Sir, I have never hurt a child.
Have you told Caden what you've done?
No.
What have you told him?
Nothing. Sir, I have been loyal to
you. You have been loyal? You have been loyal. He has been loyal.
We were on the verge of launching the most potent weapon ever created when the world is suddenly buried in water. And you are conveniently in Raina's room, as if you knew it was coming. Then the world gets repopulated, and we build the tower with the savages, and days before it goes operational, it is struck by lightning.
And then during the biggest battle since the expulsion, you disappear during the worst of it to deliver your friend to the Valley of the Song. And you try to hear the song for yourself.
I've told them nothing.
What are you getting out of all of this?
One gift we have not been given. Secret. The creation. Angels deserve every power of man is given. Strength and...
Strength? But they are weaker than you. They can't do what you can do. Unless you're equipping them. That's what you're building.
We lost because we were outnumbered. Next time, we won't.
Do you know what we do to traitors?
You're the only one still fraternizing with the enemy,
Lars. I'm not fraternizing. I would never betray our family.
And what were you doing at the canyon?
I was spying on them.
You were spying. And what did you discover, Lars?
Our administration is sending an operative.
We know that already.
I will tell you why!
You knew that we were busy fighting the king! So you took the opportunity to meet with the opposition to see if they would take you back.
Yeah.
Do you enjoy your freedom, Loras?
Yes, sir.
You think because we are bound to this rock that we cannot banish you?
I was searching for information. I heard that the rules were about to change. I heard that an operative was being sent. They're creating loopholes for the humans. They're changing the game, sir. They're changing the game. Well, sir! Please wait. Wait! Oh, I'll do anything. Don't pronounce your sentence over here, please. Don't pronounce your sentence. Please. Please. Please, I'll do anything.
Will you pose as a dead person? When one of them has died, will you appear as the deceased and console them?
I've never liked the tactic you're lying to.
We're well aware of your feelings on this matter, Loras. But you are in no position to negotiate. Do you enjoy your freedom, Loras?
Yes. I'll do it.
You know, and for the record, we're not lying to anyone. We will figure out the power of creation, and we will raise the dead. We're just letting them know that life is going on, just in a different form. It's a temporary fix. We're giving them hope, Loras. Do you understand what's really going on here?
Yes.
I don't think you do. Since day one, you have underestimated what the savages are capable of. You see them as frail and capricious, which on the surface they are. But it is because they have lost their light. They are hollow inside. And that is why we can possess them. But that also means that they can be possessed by the administration.
And if that happens, a single one of them can wipe out an entire legion. They are the most powerful weapon ever devised.
Do you repent your sins, Loras? I'm demoting you. You're a sergeant now. You're lucky that we accept you as you are. But you will have to prove your allegiance to us. You will neutralize the operative.
To talk with you anytime, Uncle Fula. My door is always open. Same goes for you, Manisiva.
Got
you.
Stand down!
Supposed to be alone.
So are you.
My apologies. As you know, everyone here is on high alert.
Why?
You're telling me you don't know.
For the record, please.
The invasion is imminent. You know it, and we know it.
What makes you think this is an invasion?
It's been previsioned.
I believe your interpretation.
My interpretation? There's heightened activity among the enemy, all concentrated in one location. They've actually abandoned their post in several places around the planet. So this is a military maneuver, plain and simple. And if it isn't, then where's Caden?
Birds is crossing enemy lines and there's much to prepare. A lot of elements need to be in place.
Explain.
They're oracles.
We've been charged with making sure everything happens according to plan.
That's a bigger responsibility.
It's a lot easier than finding suitable human guards.
They're also...
fickle.
Fickle. We know administration likes humans, so we know the prince would present himself to an interloper. We just don't know which one. Someone has to have been chosen by now, but we can't seem to find anyone who fits the required criteria.
We found one who is trustworthy.
She was everything the Oracle's predicted.
Perfect.
But there's one really big problem.
She's living in the wrong town.
What?
The prince is supposed to arrive here.
But the intermediary is...
He's over here.
How did that happen?
This is one of the most important oracles.
We know.
Everything hinges on it.
That's true, but...
Fixed it!
How?
Administration warned us ahead of time, so we...
Manipulated the system.
That was Caden's idea.
A census. They made it mandatory that all peoples return to the town of their birth. That was Caden's idea, wasn't it?
He hasn't even arrived yet, and both the angels and humans are hunting him.
He'll be fortunate to last a week on the run.
And traveling is difficult, and hiding
is expensive. He'll need money in order to survive.
What are you going to do about it? You mean scientists?
Yes, from the east. They know what's coming.
How?
They've heard the divinations, and the search is the only place they know to look.
What are they looking for?
Conjunction, an eclipse, anything significant.
But aren't those kinds of things happening all the time?
Yes, which is great for us.
They see a big enough celestial event.
Like a conjunction or a comet.
To follow it, to find them.
So you'll open their eyes?
Their eyes are already open.
We need to open the sky.
Why go through all this work to look at the stars?
Well, because of what we explained.
No. I know that. But why not just make your own?
No, we haven't been approved to build anything yet.
Not build. Just reveal yourself, you know? Allow your light to shine in the sky. To them, it'll look like a star.
That's a really great idea.
Always knew this guy was a genius.
You want it? 야곱에게서 나오며 한 기후가 이스라엘에게서 일어날 것이다.
You can't beckon just any group of astronomers.
They need to be able to aid the prince in his escape. How?
Gold.
Gold?
To pay for the escape.
And be part of the gifts they present to royalty.
This group has to be wealthy to give enough so the trip can be paid for.
And if they're short, we'll help where we can.
Mm-hmm.
The other catch is...
The group has to be foreigners. Why?
Because many of them are royalty, and if kingship from a nearby region arrives...
It'll threaten the local leaders.
So it has to be somebody from far away so the local government is not threatened.
But not so far away that it'll take them too long to arrive.
Which means that they have to leave early enough...
So that they appear exactly when the prince needs them.
Whew. They've been one step ahead of us at every turn. But all that's about to change.
How so? You found the prince? How?
All we had to do was wait at the canyon and wait for him to arrive to hear the song. And then follow him to his post.
I see. Well, if you know where he is, what are you doing here? For what?
My window.
Caden.
Has gotten into you. I thought you were friends.
Ya regresen a los puestos iniciales. Aquí tenemos controlada la situación.
I understand that the prince and the general have met. I will interview you both separately.
Gladly.
Everything all right?
Sure. Everything's fine. Everything's perfect. Everything's marvelous. There's nothing wrong.
Interview 400401. Subject, Loris. According to the record, the prince was led into the desert for the meeting. Were you there for that?
Everyone was there. We were ordered to be in attendance once he reached the wasteland. But the meeting didn't happen for at least a month.
Really? Why?
They were preparing. The general met with his confidants to discuss strategy. But the prince, well, he was alone.
What was he doing?
can tell you what he wasn't doing. Eating.
He went without food for a month?
Or water.
What?
He's not human. He only looks human. They can't live that long without hydration, trust me.
Loras, there is something I think you need to understand.
There's nothing to understand. He's wearing a disguise and hidden under that meat suit is the prince. We all know that he cannot be killed. I will say this, though. It's pretty convincing.
In that desert, his lips and skin dried out by the end of the first day. Pretty soon, he stopped sweating. His eyes sunk in, his heart rate increased. He started vomiting not long after that.
His blood pressure dropped so low, we were sure a heart attack was imminent. And then he collapsed. And he didn't get up until nightfall. It was a pretty good show. He must have known we were watching. The fever. The dizziness. That was a nice touch.
By the time he got to day 40, he could barely walk. Not for long anyway, he was just laying there, breathing heavily, covered in flies.
40 days? 40 days and he hadn't met the general yet?
Yeah, I don't know what he was thinking. I don't see how this prepares him for anything. Because by the end of that month, I didn't recognize him. You know, I haven't actually seen him since the Civil War.
Last time I saw him, he was commanding angels. He's cloaked in light. His eyes burn like twin suns. But seeing him there, that was torture.
You know, I think I know why the general insisted that we stay with him the whole time.
Why?
He wanted us to witness what the prince had become. It was not a picture of strength.
What about the general?
There's a reason why we follow him.
All of us were on one side, the displaced on the other. All of a sudden, there was an explosion in the sky.
A new kind of warfare?
No. Someone broke the sound barrier. He looked up and there he was. A general.
He flew right over us in his dazzling display and then streaked to the ground like a meteor. Now that was incredible.
He always did like to make a big entrance.
It was more stunning than I remember.
Full of wisdom.
And perfect in beauty.
He was hypnotizing. I had to pull away.
What did they talk about?
He did something that surprised us. The general asked him how he was feeling. He thought he could use some food, so he suggested he eat first.
No. There's something you're not telling me. What else did he say?
He tried to get him to doubt his identity. He said something akin to, "You're the son of the king. Turn these stones to bread."
Textbook psychological warfare. Baiting him with appetite.
He just thought he was hungry. I mean, hey, if you can't use divine power to end hunger, then what's it good for? For what it's worth, he didn't look like the son of the king. There have been plenty of imposters.
Like he didn't know.
He had to be sure.
Conniving.
Brilliant. I'm just telling you what I saw, Rena.
So was that the end of the meeting?
Oh, he was warming up. He tried to get him to kill himself.
Kill himself? How exactly would that work?
It wouldn't work. He can't die.
He can't die?
Are you sure?
Tell me something.
May I ask a question?
Why the disguise?
What's the delay?
Pauper's clothes, the illegitimate birth.
It's been 30 years and nothing's happened. When is he going to go public?
Why won't he reveal himself? Honest men have nothing to hide.
Well, the general hasn't exactly been forthcoming with his identity.
We're not done.
The general unveiled his true position?
The god of the earth.
God?
The prince was taken to the best view on the planet.
And believe it or not, he offered him the world if...
If what?
If he bowed down to the general.
Oh, it was just a gesture. A sign of respect.
He didn't just want the physical act. He wanted to be worshipped.
How could he possibly justify this?
It's the same thing we are commanded to give administration when we're in their domain. And he refused. That's how much he hates equality.
Do you actually believe that you and the prince are on the same level? Huh? So how did this all end? Why don't you tell me this? What were you two fighting about? What were you two fighting about?
Leaves the desert, you take him out.
Prête l'oreille à mes paroles, ô Éternel. Sois attentif à mes cris, mon roi. C'est à toi que j'adresse ma prière. Éternel.
Are we still doing this?
Yes. Come inside.
How does it feel?
I thought you said you just wanted the facts.
This isn't for the record. I just need to know.
I didn't think you would go through with it, Raina. I don't know how to feel. Can we just start the recorder?
Interview 431916.
Subject: Loris. Go ahead. Give me your version of the events.
I don't really know how to explain it.
Just say it.
He's dead. The prince. Lynched by the very beings created in his image. It's kind of ironic, really. What you have to understand is that the general told us that the prince's arrival was an invasion, and our orders were to stop him. This is our kingdom, and we have to defend it. That's not what he really wanted. All along, the general's goal was to destroy him.
And you complied? He may have given the orders, but you participated in the execution. Stop shifting the blame!
Raina, the general promised us freedom. I swear I never knew it was going to be at the expense of the life giver. I didn't even know he could die.
P 없이는 제사함이 없다. Now you know why the king cast you to Earth. He could have sent you to the center of a star, or into the bowels of a black hole.
He just wanted us out of the kingdom.
No! Loris, no! He sent you to Earth to witness the death of his son.
General, never. We all love the prince.
You were saying?
I didn't want it to end like this, Cade.
End? You think this is over? I can't do this.
Raina, we have to. It's important.
I know. But I was...
What?
Nothing. Caden, why don't you state what you witnessed?
It was madness. Chaos. You've seen mobs. You know how they work? They dragged him away in the middle of the night and had a trial.
if you want to call it that. They were determined to kill him by any means necessary. They spat on him. Beat him. Tortured him. And the entire time, like a lamb ready for slaughter, he was silent.
I don't understand. Why would the prince do this to the savages? They're so wicked.
They're wicked?
And who said it was just for them? Caden, you were saying?
I have seen bodies floating like fish in the sea as whole civilizations were washed away. Smelled rotting flesh as pestilence excoriated the corpses of thousands. Heard infant scream and sacrificial fires. But nothing could have prepared me for the moment when he took his last breath. Even the sun refused to shine. For some reason, I couldn't look away. You could tell that a bond was broken.
Trinity was shattered.
And this was the plan? I thought they were giving out pardons.
His death was the pardon!
Why would administration want that?
He didn't want that. He begged for release 3 times.
He could have come off the cross anytime he wanted to. He had the power to do that.
Now, the universe knows the difference between the viciousness of the arch-apostate, your general, and the tenderness of the prince.
Should have been me. I offered my own life, but it wasn't enough.
What are you talking about?
I was ready to give my life for the mortals, just so he wouldn't have to.
Why didn't they let you?
Because the plan required the death of God.
Please don't.
Just give me a minute.
How can you stand there so calloused?
I'm not. This is killing me too, Caden.
You had the nerve to come into this office with his blood still on your hands?
I was under orders. Jesus.
Don't you dare say his name after what you've done!
I've done nothing but defend my home!
But his death!
His death was a fatal blow to his kingdom! He should have never have come here!
You have doomed yourself, Lars. Loyalty to the general has blinded you.
Shut up!
You're so busy mocking the prince, you didn't see him when he looked at you.
Shut up!
He's gasping for air.
Madame, tu entends ma voix.
Clinging to life. Pleading to Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
Le matin, je me tourne vers toi.
I have tried to save you, my brother. But you've gone too far. Goodbye, Loras. It is finished.
I shall look out.
Did you see it?
Oh. See what?
The green flash.
When the sun is near the horizon, the rays of light are split as they pierce through the atmosphere. The more atmosphere the rays pass through, the more the rays are split. That's why the light changes color. From red to orange to yellow. Why would it turn green? Because green is the next color on the spectrum. If the air is holding any mist or smoke, it will split the light, enabling us to see it. All the elements must be in the perfect place. And so, here you are, the right place at the right time. Would you like some tea?
I would offer you some crumpets, but they haven't been invented yet. I'm positive that will make a good joke someday. Maybe it's my timing.
Thank you for seeing me. Not sure what to say.
Je n'ai pas besoin de dire quoi que ce soit. Je suis heureuse de t'avoir à mes côtés.
Had a tough week.
Nothing compared to you.
Oui. Il a été difficile pour nous tous. Did you bring me a present?
Not exactly. I need to
talk to you about my job. When I was given this task, I knew exactly what was required of me. When I sit in that chair and I press that record button and I hear those wheels hum, I know absolute objectivity is demanded.
But you're not exactly an impartial observer.
That shouldn't matter. Observation without participation, that is the job. And I made a mistake.
No, you didn't.
I broke protocol. I let my feelings get in the way. I allowed a fight to break out in my office, and I did nothing to stop it. I'm not cut out for this job. These old stories that I hear, they affect me too deeply.
You want to resign?
There are needs in other areas.
May I?
I have heard that Antilia is in need of a surveyor. Middle West is enacting their initiatives and needs an accountant. There are places I could be of service.
And would that make you happy?
My work is essentially complete.
You think the job is done? Interesting.
What else is there? The prince has made his sacrifice. The general's nature has been exposed. Isn't it over?
Have you ever seen an Oryctolagus canigullus?
A rabbit?
Yes. Did you know they can see nearly 360 degrees?
No.
It's because of the shape of their eyes. Not only that, but their hearing is highly acute. And they can feel the vibrations through the earth. Isn't that remarkable?
Yes.
But here's something even more interesting. When they are born, they are both blind and deaf. They don't even have their own immune systems. That they get from their mothers when they nurse. It's called passive immunity. Humanity is no different. They are born blind and diseased, with no immunity to destruction.
I thought all that had changed. Haven't they all been pardoned?
The pardon is available, but they have to choose it. And they cannot do that if they don't have the facts. That, my dear, is where you come in.
Yes, but you need someone who can keep their feelings out of it.
I need you, sweet Reyna. Don't you know that I chose you? Because you feel so deeply. It matters to us what you think. These events are more than just facts. Just as you are more than just photons. These reports must be studied and discussed. They will be opened before civilizations that have not yet been created. Everyone must decide on their own. If we are fair.
So it isn't over.
It isn't over until the last child has made their choice. We do this because we cannot risk the possibility of this ever happening again.
Je ne sais pas si je peux.
Toi. Tu es la prunelle de mes yeux. Je veux que tu sois heureuse.
Le choix est le tien.
Oh, and one more thing. Can you please have Atlan prepare the room?
Why?
Someone is coming in today to give a report.
And you want Atlan to do it?
Well, if you're no longer taking reports, then yes. Although he did request you.
Who did?
The prince.
The prince? He's coming to my office? He's giving a report. And he asked for me. Are you sure?
I am.
once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace that brought
Neil, Sergeant Kidd.
Kijk, hoe goed en hoe lieflijk is doet dat broer zo ook samen. Doet het zoals die kostbare olie op de hoef van Kidd. Wat afloopt op zich zich. Wat afloopt op de zoom van zijn kleer.
Arise, brother. You're a guardian now.
Been here 10,000.